From a young age, there's evidence that Cloud struggled with elements of mental health. He had trouble making friends, and a sensitivity to rejection that he masked with false confidence. And, most notably, the beginnings of his lifelong battle with survivor's guilt. The adults of the village immediately place blame on Cloud, which he then internalizes. In fact, these feelings influenced him so strongly that he felt that he had to go out and join Shinra in order to prove that he was worth something. While he had plenty of physical capabilities, there was already underlying mental vulnerabilities. These issues are compounded even further with Zack's death. Zack Fair is a traditional hero in every way. He made Soldier First Class shockingly young, is bright, outgoing, and steadfast in his desire to always do what's right. He refuses to leave Cloud behind, and eventually gives his life for him. Cloud, whose mind is already so fragile and poisoned, cannot cope with the horror he's experienced, so he latches onto the person he always wanted to be. Just like when he was a child, he tries to mentally separate himself from the situation and convince himself that he's emotionally uninvolved. Cloudstrife isn't who he says he is. A sensitive and deeply damaged individual. Without his delusions of grandeur, Cloud is almost painfully real. He's a failure. He's not even sure he even really existed. His entire personality is a construct brought on by a twisted experiment and intense mental trauma. But because it's almost an upsettingly realistic example of the effects of trauma and Cloud's constant battle with his own mind.
Tifa, I'm not fit to help anyone. Not my family, not my friends, nobody.
He also cannot erase the effects of his own traumatic history and mental weaknesses. These are not problems that can be defeated just once, but innate parts of himself that Cloud must learn to live with and combat his entire life. Learning to manage a mental illness is full of trial and error. Some days are worse than others, and recovery is very rarely linear. We are seeing him at his lowest with his struggle with depression and PTSD. Illnesses that by nature rob an individual of their true personality. I know from personal experience that the person I am when I'm depressed is not who I really am. It's absolutely devastating to think that the world would only remember me by who I am when I'm at my worst. Cloud's struggle with his own identity is once again lost to his trauma.
Don't run. Let's fight it together. We can help each other. I know we can. Dilly dally shilly shally. Dilly dally shilly shally.
I think she wants you to move on, man.
Stop running! I know. Even if you find the kids, you might not be able to help them. Maybe something will happen that can never unhappen. That scares you, doesn't it?
Forget it, Cloud. Why don't you ever pay any attention to us?
But you need to think about now. Really take it in. Look at you. You think you've got it so damn hard. Well, you hate being alone, so let people in. Sure, you might not answer the phone, but I don't see you throwing it away either. Which is it? A memory or us?
I let you die.
I never blamed you. Not once. That's all that matters.